Welcome to Brownfield High with Zane Woodin. And here we have
JC Carillo,
aka Lil Chihuahua. And
Zaris Garcia,
aka Papi Chuo. Today we'll be talking about our upcoming football games. So, JC, how do you think we did against Kermit and Slayton? Like, how would you say the performance was?
We did great. Energy was there from the start. Energy was there from Monday, when we should have had energy throughout the whole season, but barely hit when we hit district. Our quarterback did good. I think like 4 or 5 touchdowns that day, something like that. Almost 200 yards. Our line did excellent. Receivers, excellent. Had some good plays. It was just an overall good performance. Slayton, we had a good dub. We didn't quit, even though we didn't score on the first 2 drives that we had. And then we ended up winning. So, a good 2 weeks left.
Speaking of that few touchdowns, as Ari said, how does that make you feel? I'm not going to lie. You've probably been our best offensive player throughout these 2 weeks that we've had our wins.
Thank you.
How does
that
make you feel?
Makes me feel amazing, you know, to go out there and get the dub for our team. Feels great.
Feels great. All right. So, our upcoming district, right now we're 2-1.
Yes, we are.
So we have Denver City coming up next, right? What do you think our final record could be, and what do you wish it to be?
How many games? We have, what, 2 more games
left? 2 more games.
Oh, 4-1. We can be. That's what I want to. Yeah, that's about it.
What about you?
We could be 4-1 if everyone would buy in and actually want to win some games. They know who they are.
Okay, so we already know about the Denver City's real good 6-man box. How do you think our O-line would fare against them?
I feel like they'll struggle at the beginning, trying to figure out where they need to be and all that. But I think our coaches will help them out, and at the end of the game, we'll do great.
And for you, since you're mainly on the defensive side, how do you think our defense will go against their offense?
The defense has been clicking lately. We haven't let up that much touchdowns. We haven't been putting our heads down like we normally have past years. And Lane Bundy stepping into Sisson's spot. It's kind of hard for Lane to do, I guess. Austin Sisson is a D1 prospect.
D1.
Then you got Gunnels.
Who has improved over the past 2 weeks? You can't lie. He has been getting some tackles.
Yeah, Gunnels has been getting tackles, but he's still a B, DBAB Gunnels.
All right, next question. Who's our best lineman? We already know the answer, but, you know, just want to hear from the players.
Oh, you already know. Zayden Modine, best lineman we got, baby.
Zayden, nothing but pancakes over on his side.
Hear that, Keyshawn? I'm way better than you. You'll never be as good as me. You're trash. All right, well, that's all I have for you
today.
Pleasure to have you on the show. Pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you for having
me. Thank you.
I'm the best in the nation. So we have some former players, now turned fans. Look at the smiles on these guys' faces. I'm so happy. All right. So y'all seen how the Cubs have improved, right, over the past 2 weeks? Mm-hmm. You actually made a bet with one of your friends that we wouldn't win a game the whole season.
Y'all would win.
No, that we would get. Yeah, but he said we wouldn't.
Yeah, they wouldn't. And yeah.
Now he owes him $100. Joey just got $100. What? You're welcome.
Thank you.
And Zach, so as an Al fan, how do you think our season's been going?
Honestly, y'all have improved quite a bunch. Honestly, when I was playing, well, I didn't play, but you know, you feel me? You know, y'all started out a bit sluggish, but when district hit, I mean, y'all turned on the Jets. I mean, y'all been going. Keyshawn out there getting pancakes. Not as many as Zayd, but I mean, hey, Zayd's the best they got. It's all behind Zayd. All
right, so yeah. Speaking off of that, who's the best lineman on the team?
That's hard. I'm gonna have to go with Zayden.
It's not hard.
I'm gonna have to go with Zayden.
Yeah. These are from our own fans, Keyshawn. I'm literally better than you. Come on now. Just accept it, man. All right. So from us going 0-5 in our regular season games to being 2-1 in district, that's amazing, huh?
Yeah,
that's amazing. Yeah. All right. So over our next 2 games, how do you feel we good? We could do.
Should I work together? Don't give up on no plays. y'all will be 4-1. No doubt.
You?
I mean, hey, y'all got a shot against Denver City and Lumisa. I mean, hey, y'all can do this. I got this in the bag.
We're playoff bound. Thanks for having me on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Lindsay.
Ivan.
Tay. And today we're going to be playing Finish the Lyric. Our first contestant will be Lindsay.
I got to finish it. I want to paint. She wanted things. She want.
Hey, Drake fan, I just want to put that out there. She said Drake's her favorite artist. I don't believe that. All right, so Lindsay has been eliminated. Next, we have Ivan. He said his artist is Lil Wayne.
Yep. Dreams transform to something, and I forgot what the rest was.
All right, so Ivan has been eliminated. Next up is Levante, and he chose Ian Dior.
Got another memory to hold it inside. No? What?
Last round, Levante was eliminated. No, none of the contestants got it right, so we got two more contestants.
Thomas Brisendine.
Zachary Gonzalez.
And today, Thomas chose Greta Van Fleet.
I have no idea.
Well.
Unfortunately, you've been eliminated.
All right, Thomas was eliminated, and all we have is Zach. His artist was Lil Uzi Vert.
I really couldn't even tell you, dude.
That is.
And finally, we have JC. Your last resort right now, since other contestant. Missed it, and he chose Polo G.
All night I stayed up staring into the picture.
Yo!
Yo, you got it!
And look at this new trophy you got.
A new hubcap.
A new hubcap. Thank you. This was Finish the Lyric.